Hare Krishna.
Just because pain is circumstantially beneficial doesn't mean it is intrinsically desirable. We all face pain, distress, misfortune in life. And when we see that this such unhappiness is inherent to the world, everyone goes through it sometime or the other, the question may come up, why is such pain present? Now some people say that actually pain and pleasure are just two sides of the same coin, and pain helps us to appreciate pleasure better. Loss helps us to appreciate gain better. Yes, that is true. So we could say that pain is circumstantially beneficial. That when, say, if we put our hand in fire and we feel the burning sensation, then that makes us move away from fire and that protects us. So the pain we feel on putting hand in fire is beneficial. So similarly, when we experience loss, when we have experienced poverty, then when we have prosperity, we cherish it more. That is true. This is circumstantially beneficial. But that doesn't mean it is intrinsically desirable. That no one will put their hand in fire so that they can get relief from fire by putting their hand out. Nobody will voluntarily become poor, just squander all their money and live in poverty so that they can appreciate wealth better. So if they do that, they will want to be able to have the freedom to change it immediately. People may just do a masquerade, be a fancy dress party, they may act like a beggar. So pain is not intrinsically desirable. Then why is it present in this world? It is because that pain is meant to prompt us to ask fundamental questions about life, to ask fundamental questions about the nature of the world. The Bhagavad Gita explains that we are at our core souls. We are spiritual beings and we belong to a spiritual level of reality. Presently, we exist at the material level, and the distress at the material level is meant to prompt us to spiritualize our consciousness. Krishna points to this in the Bhagavad Gita 8.15, when he states that mamupetya punarjanma dukkhalyam ashashvatam naapnuvanti mahatmanah samsiddhim paramam gatah. He says, those who devote themselves to me, they do not return to this distressful, temporary material world, but they attain my eternal abode. So we have to acknowledge that this world is dukkhalayam, that it is, and dukkha is undesirable. That yes, while we are living in the world, we will have to go through happiness and distress, and distress can may help us to appreciate happiness better. But what our heart longs for is ultimately a state of constant happiness, a state of freedom from distress. And that is what we should aspire for. So rather than accepting that distress is just a part of material life and therefore stay on in material life, we can say that distress is a part of material life, but we don't have to be a part of material consciousness and material world. When we practice spirituality determinedly, then, and we see the distresses of this world as prompters, as pushers for us to spiritualize our consciousness, then we will be able to attain the happiness that we long for, free from distress. So rather than making this pain as a virtue intrinsically, we see pain as a circumstantial virtue to prompt us towards spiritual consciousness. Thank you. Hare Krishna.